Let's see how QXPMarkz works with its scripts in InDesign. When you first run QXPMarkz, you'll see that you'll have a window here for script installer and then activate. You can still install the scripts in freebie mode, which is unactivated mode, but they won't run or do anything in InDesign. So let's activate QXPMarkz and then we'll install the scripts. Okay, I've activated QXPMarkz, so I'm going to go ahead and close the window. You can see successfully activated, status activated, and now we have our scripts window. If you don't want this window to come up every time that you start QXPMarkz, you can uncheck this box. And if that happens and you restart it doesn't come up, you can go up here to the Tools menu and always bring it back up. So if I close it, go to the Tools menu and do Scripts Installer, it comes back up. So we're going to use InDesign 2020 for this, so I'm going to click on Install. It's going to ask me for my password. And now the script is installed in InDesign. As you can see, there's quite a few versions of InDesign listed here. QXPMarkz went out and looked on my system to see what versions of InDesign I had installed, and it goes back to CS6. So you can install the scripts all the way back to InDesign CS6. Now let's take a look at how the scripts look in InDesign. So this is InDesign CC or InDesign 2020, and once the scripts are installed, there's a new item here in the main menu bar called Markzware, and it has a script called Convert QuarkXPress Document. Also under the File menu, there's a new item called Open QuarkXPress File. Both of these will invoke QXPMarkz, which needs to be activated in order for this to work. So let's see how this works. I'll just use the Markzware menu and select Convert QuarkXPress Document. That's going to bring up a dialog and ask me to select a Quark file to convert. So I'm going to select this file here, and let's see what happens. Ooh, two documents opened up. The reason for this is because if your Quark file contains multiple layouts, each layout will open in a separate tab. So this is layout one we're looking at here, and this is layout two. And now, once I've done that, QXPMarkz is out of the picture and you're in InDesign. You can go ahead and do whatever edits you'd like to do. We can put things in here. We can shrink things up. However you want to edit it, you now have an InDesign file. And QXPMarkz did all of the work behind the scenes. So if you'd like to open another file, just go here to Convert QuarkXPress or go to the File menu and do Open QuarkXPress File. So using the scripts that come with QXPMarkz keeps you in your flow in InDesign, hopefully saving you time and making your life a bit easier.